girl, Kristen Ayana, and welcome to my new series called Drew University on the Path, where I interview college students about relationships, college life, and more. So, first, tell me, what's the worst date you've ever been on?
To be honest, like, my dating life has been pretty boring, but I would say, like, the worst experience in terms of dating has been, like, when I was with my, like, first girlfriend. We went on a date to the movies, and she didn't like the movie, and she didn't talk to me the whole time, and then I tried to take her out to dinner, she didn't talk to me the whole time, and then at the end, I was just like, yo, alright, but I'm getting hurt, and then the next day, she was like, wait, why didn't you call me? So...
Okay.
Yeah, very weird.
That's kind of weird. That probably is like an awkward experience.
Very awkward. Very awkward.
What's the worst date you've ever been on? The worst date that I've ever been on, I didn't know it was a date at first, and my friend took me to a mountain to go skiing because he wanted to teach me how to ski. So I was like, oh my gosh, I want to learn how to ski. It was great. But he got super nervous and didn't teach me how to stop. So I fell down the hill, three children, and then a fence, and broke this fence. And like the children were like crying. And his boss like skied up to me and he skied away. And let his boss like yell at me for being on the mountain unattended. And I was like, why didn't you teach me how to stop?
Right.
And he said, because I was super nervous because we're on a date and I like didn't know. Like super awkward. I went home and
hurt. Did you ever talk to him again?
Yeah, like as friends though. Like I was like, well, I'm just gonna let it go.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, I could imagine after that. It's like,
yeah.
Okay. Second question now is, how do you feel about the talking stage?
You know, the talking stage is like the easiest part of the whole relationship. You're talking to each other. You're getting to know each other. It's all fun and games. It's easy. You ask them a question, they ask you a question. The point is to get to know each other, right?
Right.
No need to be stressed out. I mean, I also do what you do, so like, is it really that hard for us?
Right. But also, do you feel like it's important to like go out with someone like while you guys are talking?
Yeah,
like,
absolutely.
Spend time with each other? Because I feel like sometimes people...
skip over that part a little
bit.
Yeah. See, the talking stage is where you build the foundation. So you go do new things with each other, you go try foods, you go see new things and all that. And that builds a foundation, that builds a friendship, and that's important for when you jump off into a relationship. Because once that ends, if that ends, and you decide to fall back into friendship, where's that friendship gonna go if you don't have anything to land on?
Right.
You didn't?
That was really good.
Yeah.
That's the answer.
Wait.
Okay. So tell me, how do you feel about the talking stage?
Personally, I think that it shouldn't really exist because talking can mean lots of different things to different people, so I feel like talking is too broad. I think there should be like a getting to know you stage versus talking, and then during that stage, I feel like you can honestly just do whatever you want to get to know each other, go on dates, like chill, relax, or whatever, FaceTime, but I don't think it should be like as important as some people take it.
Okay. That's a reasonable answer. Yeah. Okay, so tell us, what is the worst date you've ever been on?
Alright, so one time in high school, it was like my first date ever, and I had to like ask my mom if I could go because I was like 14. And my mom was like, I mean, I guess, like, do I know him? And it was like the same kid that I let like, know forever, so I was like, okay. So basically, he came and his dad drove us to Applebee's, and he threw up on the table at Applebee's. Yeah, it was fucking gross.
Wow.
Yeah.
So after that, did you just like, okay, bye, or?
No, I was pretty evil at that point in my life, so I told everybody about it, and people like made fun of him.
It's an evil world we live in.
Yeah, we're friends now though, it's fine.
Okay, so what is the worst date you've ever been on?
Okay, so it was a double date, and him and his friend were an hour late to the movie, which really sucked, and then afterwards, we were like driving to get food and he started smoking in my friend's car, like hot pots.
Damn, so disrespectful.
Yeah, it is.
Okay. Okay, so tell me, how do you feel about the talking stage?
I feel like it's hard because like when you're gonna be my boyfriend, like what's going on? And like sometimes it's just like, oh, let's hook up. Mm-hmm. But it's like
I want you to be my boyfriend. What else is going to happen out of this?
Right. So it's like you feel like it's a never
ending thing. Yeah, it just keeps going on and on. And then sometimes they just like stop talking to you and you're like, okay, hello.
Yeah, that can definitely be an issue.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do you feel about the talking stage?
Personally, I'm not a big fan of the talking stage, or you know what, I feel like it should be a very short stage within your relationship with someone.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't mind talking to someone for a week, getting in a FaceTime, you know, trying to see if we vibe, and if we do, then we like want to date. If we like each other, then we start dating. I don't know. I feel like a lot of the time the talking stage is like stretched out and it becomes a waste of everyone's time because the other person doesn't even have the intention of like being serious with you. So.
Right. Okay, so tell me, what is the worst date you've ever been on?
The worst date? It's gonna take me a minute. I met this girl, right? She was cute, whatever the case may be. But I'm more of a personality type of person, so I took it to Chipotle. Because we love much Chipotle, right? And we're sitting there, and I'll be like, yo, how's your dad? And she was like, fine. And I'm like, okay, like, what is your favorite food? And she was like, ham. And I was like, so my back started hurting. You wanna know why? Because I got tired of carrying this conversation. So I got up and I left, and she had to drive herself back home. But at the same time, it's like, nah, I'm playing with you. I came back, I gave it back. I'm not gonna do a date like that. But at that point, like, I was just like, I just stopped talking to her. It was a waste of my time to take you all the way to Chipotle because I appreciate more of like, bonding wise and setting a foundation instead of looks. So you can look as pretty as you want, but if your attitude nasty, you're not keeping it.
Period! 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 Period!
What is the worst date you've ever been on?
The worst date I've ever been on was probably thinking that I was going to go on a date with someone and then ending up at that person's house.
Mm-hmm.
It was dead, yeah.
Fuck no, baby!
So it wasn't even really a date, but it was like, it was a scam.
A scam?
That's what it was.
Oh my gosh, that must have been terrible.
Yeah, okay.
Gordon. Oh, gotcha. I got it.
You got it?
Yeah.
All right, guys. Welcome back. Welcome to the main Kristen show, the Kristen show. But Kristen, let me ask you a question. You ready for this?
What's your question?
What's the worst date you ever had?
The worst thing that I ever had, honestly, the guy told me that he had a daughter on the date.
That ain't no problem.
No, that is a big problem. It's a problem indeed.
Indeed. How come? You can take care of you too.
I just feel like once you have a child, like,